Hey everyone, so let's give it up for today's guest. And well, today's guest is, well, it's me. So I'm gonna talk about my life, and well, first things first, I'm gonna talk about my childhood, because that's how our life starts. So when I was a child, well, mom and dad were the most important persons to me. They were really good. They loved me so much, and things were simple. Life was simple, and they were just black and white. Like, there were no gray areas. Things were just good or they were just bad. I haven't had to choose between a bad thing or a more bad thing. Well, that wasn't there. And well, I have some really good memories with my parents. Well, I remember this ground which used to be in front of my house, which we used to go to. Well, I used to go it with my dad to play cricket on a Sunday morning. And well, while putting the stumps in the ground, there was always this third stump that never really stuck, and it was really a pain in the ass at that time. But well now it's a good memory. It has a really good place in my heart. Well, and one day I finally grew up, and I didn't know what to do. So well, as my whole childhood, I turned to my parents, and well, as everybody's parents, they said, beta doctor ban lo ya fir engineering kar lo. So I thought that if that's what they'll make them happy, then well, I'll do engineering. I'll become an engineer. And well, let's be frank, that's the first lie they ever told me. Ki beta 10th kar lo, life set hai. Beta 12th kar lo, life set hai. Beta engineering kar lo, life set hai. But whatever the fuck I do right now, my life will never be set. Well, that's the truth. I just said it. So well, I worked my ass off in the JEE exam. Well, I got into a decent college. Well, it wasn't an IIT, and I didn't think that. I thought that my parents would be happy, well, happier if I got into an IIT, but it wasn't. It was a big joint for sure. So I felt good. I don't think that my parents felt good at that time, but well, I didn't care at that time. So, well, in my first year, 1,000 new students meet each other, and no one really knows anyone else.
You had plenty money, 1941. You lost it all, and then away you run. Why don't you do right like some other men do?
So I thought that if I wear a mask, if I pretend to be happy,
get me some money too,
then I'll make friends, I'll become popular.
You're sitting down wondering what it's all about.
And well, it did work. It kind of worked, and I made friends.
Like some other men do.
And the number of friends grew. I became really popular on the campus. And it was good going. It was really, really smoothly running. And on the surface, life really seemed good. Well, and as gradually time passed by, the mask seemed to be kind of frustrating for me. It seemed to be trapping me. It seemed to have set some standards that I have to act when I'm around people. And the standards that I kind of agreed at the start, but I don't really care about them right now. And I can't afford to do that. I have to act good. I have to act likable. and it felt tedious for me. I can't afford to do that anymore.
Well, I don't want to pretend anymore. I just want to take out the mask. I'll do anything in my life right now to just take off the mask and be myself. Well, to confess to you, I'm depressed right now. I'm really sad right now. And I blame the mask. The mask is the reason for this. It tortured me for a really long time. I can't describe the pain that I have to go every time I just smile to people when I don't really want to. Well, you may look at me and say he's a really happy guy and he might smile back, but you don't know that I'm fucking depressed from the inside. You can't relate to it. So, to let go out the pain, I cry every night. It feels relief a bit, but you don't know what depression's like. Well, you're watching this right now and you can't relate to me. So you know what? Let me tell you about my nightmares. Guess now you kind of know how I feel. Well, I hope so. So, as I'm confessing right now, let me tell you the biggest mistake of my life. Drugs. Thank you.
did I do it? Why did I take drugs? Well, it's simple. I wanted to escape the pain, even just for a moment. If I could believe that there was none of this shit in my life, I would do it. So, I guess I did it. And it felt really good. The pain really vanished. It felt like I was back to those good old days in my childhood, where all those minute little things mattered and not the bigger picture. Well, it turned out to be a regret of my life, but it served its purpose for that moment. Well, drugs are quite an addiction, and I wasn't able to manage any stuff in my life. Well, I'm not sad that I did it. I was kind of happy at that moment, but I just couldn't manage stuff.
So, you're wondering why you're seeing this footage, because by the time you see this, I'll probably be dead. Well, this is my last moment, so why don't I tell you how I feel? What my reality is?
Well, you know what? I really thought about telling my depression to my parents. But I didn't really think that they would understand any of this. So I lied to them. And I wore the mask entire time I talked to them. I usually stand alone, evaluating my life, thinking about the things that went wrong, and maybe that I could have done things that would change them. Well, sometimes I wear headphones just for the sake of it, without no music, and I wonder how I have over 1200 followers on Instagram and not a single one gives damn about me when I'm about to make the decision to end my life. Sometimes I cry in the shower, well, because it's just a private space and nobody gives a damn what I do when I'm in it. I feel like I'm a shell. I'm a human without the human part. I feel like the world is crashing on me, on this shell, and I think that I'm already dead. I just want to get rid of this body, and I'll be really happy when I do it. Well, I believe that there is this flame inside everyone, well, which I call hope, you know, hope for the better day. Hope for things to go good again. Well, that silver lining to that dark cloud. Well, my flame has extinguished a long time ago. The only thing that I have in my life right now is only that dark fucking cloud.
Well, I think it's time to die.